My name is Marc Murphy. I'm chef and owner of 4 restaurants in Manhattan. But where I like to cook best is in my own kitchen, in my own house. Welcome to my home. I got started cooking when I moved to New York. I was about 19 years old and didn't really know what to do with my life, but I knew I loved to eat. So I thought, well, maybe I should go learn how to cook.
Yeah.
I live in downtown Manhattan in a loft-style apartment. It's got a lot of big windows. It's very light and airy. It's got flow. There's no real walls up in the area where you live. It's dining room, kitchen, everything's all together. Up here, this is my living room. It's a very big living room and it can accommodate a lot of people. And then when we walk over this way over here, this is our, what we call our second dining room. It's probably about 18 feet long. They had to actually crane it into the apartment. It wouldn't fit up the staircase or in the elevator. But it's an absolutely amazing table. It's one piece of wood. It seats 20 people, which obviously, as you see right now, it's set up with art books. But when we do have a big dinner party, you can take the art books out and we have fold-up chairs in a closet and it becomes a dining room, which is really kind of cool. And then we can come down here, our everyday dining table. This is sort of the more casual dining area. This is where we have breakfast every day. What I love about it is we sort of design it kind of like a restaurant. This is actually a restaurant banquette. It's a really nice sort of casual spot just to hang out. The other thing that's great about it is it's right next to the kitchen. So when I'm cooking, people are hanging out here having drinks sometimes, and the main room is almost part of the kitchen, or it actually is part of the kitchen, which works out really well. I can still be part of the action, so to speak. So let's go into the kitchen. So I have 2 kitchens here. One of them is where I do most of my work, which is the front, which is nice and open, and I can be with everybody while I'm cooking. It's got a great amount of room to hold all the pots and pans. So the back kitchen's this way. That's where I can do all the dirty work and things that are a little bit more messy. This comes in quite handy because now I got myself a huge oven here. I've also got 2 wall ovens right here, which are very, very handy. You know, what I like about this pantry is there's no doors on it, so you can just, once again, stand here and see what you need. Also, another piece of equipment I don't think I can live without is a nice, big cutting board. So we're gonna use this one while we prepare some food in the front kitchen. For me, the kitchen is really the center of the home. That's where everything happens. That's where everybody hangs out. That's where everybody gathers. That's where everybody hangs around and eats. So that's where everything starts from. Today I'm having a few friends over, so I'm making a very simple but very tasty dish. Roast chicken. I'm going to be doing a pomme d'arfum, which is sort of a potato cake, and some leeks vinaigrette. So the chickens are the first things we're going to throw into the oven. Now here we go. We've got the chickens. We're going to put some salt and pepper on the inside. Shove a lemon in there, put my herbs, throw some garlic, and put another lemon in there. All right, what's great about cooking in your own kitchen is most of the time you don't have any time constraints. Like in the restaurant when you're cooking, you still have people coming over, you gotta get it done by a certain amount of time. But when you're at home, it's just much more, it's a more relaxed atmosphere. You can just sort of dilly-dally, so to speak. A little olive oil on them, and then season heavily. And this guy here, I'm gonna put him in at like 450 for, this is a pretty big bird, so I would say this one's gonna take about an hour. All right, see you guys later. All right, so now we're gonna wash the leeks. I've got a bowl. Take your leeks, cut the tail end of it off, and then come right close to it, and cut it down the middle. And then you're just gonna wanna soak those, because you wanna make sure you get all the dirt out. You know what, it looks like the water's boiling for the leeks, so I could probably throw that in there. Take my leeks, salted water. My favorite type of food to cook is the easy food. Stuff that's just simple, plain, no complicated ingredients. So a pomme d'arfum, in essence, is just like a big potato pancake. And I just like making them because they look really a lot fancier than they are. But it's very simple. So you just take potatoes, you're gonna shred them on a mandolin. One of my favorite tools in my kitchen is the Japanese mandolin. I use it for a lot of things.
I just toss a little bit of butter in that, salt and pepper, and we'll sear it just like a potato pancake. Really, really simple to make.
The ingredients usually speak for themselves, so the more simple, the better it is for me.
Look at those chickens. Now they're ready.
I think the key to making a really good roast chicken is a high heat in the oven.
Look at this chicken. I mean, there's nothing better than a nice, crispy skinned chicken.
You want to make sure you start it and all the way through, so it cooks all the way through and all those juices get sealed in.
My friend should be walking in any minute now.
I think one of the most important things with the potatoes is getting the outside crispy and getting the inside cooked all the way through.
Here they are. Beautiful. One of my favorite vegetables here.
One of the most important things when you're making leeks vinaigrette is to make sure you cook your leeks enough.
You know, at home, I always do it like this. I like to keep it family style, simple. Here they are.
Hey, what's up, man?
How's it,
buddy?
Got a little lunch for you.
How do you get the skin so crispy?
High heat in the oven, baby. And all right here in my kitchen. Well, I hope you enjoyed the stay in my kitchen and got to see me make a little bit of lunch. Now we're just gonna finish up and enjoy. Cheers.